Bobcat can't get on your post. This one, so this tab is gonna be the live,
okay,
so we can watch the live, and then, which, I mean, we don't need the live because it's basically that,
yeah,
but if we, you know, whatever, and then there's a tab, second tab for you.
Okay.
No, I'm going to go ahead and copy this so I don't have to worry about this.
Test 1 2. Test 1 2.
Mic check 1.
Mic check. Check.
1 2 3. Mic check. Here's
2 3 4.
You don't hear me, Mo? Did you go? Did you find there?
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, if you want to pull it up there, so you don't have to pull up your phone. This is it's a district website. So, I mean, it's a district Wi-Fi. So you should be able to find everything, but there's certain sites they may not let you go to.
Okay.
You may have to use your phone for that. Yeah. Mic check 1 2 3. Can you hear me, Coach Mo? Can
Mike
you hear
one,
me? Can you
Mike
hear me,
one.
Mo? From the Starts Mr. Bobcat, Story
right
Purvey
side.
Here, sitting in the corner, the northwest corner of the Star Spencer Johnson Johnson Gymnasium. You got me, Mo?
How you got me? 1 2 3. Philip Cowart on the color tonight from the Johnson Johnson Gymnasium.
This is the Johnson Johnson Gymnasium, but it's the what court is this, Mo? What's the name of the court? Johnson Johnson Court? Johnson Johnson Fieldhouse and the court. Home of the Star Spencer Bobcats, Navy and White, against Heritage Hall, who
are. I can mute y'all.
There's probably it.
Oh, yeah. That muted.
So you can't hear it then? Okay. Yeah. So we won't be talking. I'm just going to make some copies of the girls.
Thank you.
just started as a lunch check.
Oh, sweet.
Thank you.
Welcome, everybody, to the Star Spencer versus Heritage Hall, Star Spencer Bobcats versus Heritage Hall Chargers game here at the Johnson Johnson Fieldhouse at Star Spencer High School. I'm Tori Purvey. I am your color announcer. Also with...
This is Philip Coward. You said you're going to be the color announcer tonight. So
well, you, I mean...
We're going to work together.
Well, we're going to work together.
I'm
in tandem with...
Yes, I'm excited to be working with you tonight. This is my first time at a Star Spencer sporting event or basketball event. And
right.
I'm excited and looking forward to a good match, a good basketball game here in Spencer.
All right. We'll get to the starting lineup in a second as the game gets started, but our referees are Billy Truong, Rick Dupuy, and Princeton Johnson. Star Spencer seemed to have a very heavy upperclassmen starting the game tonight, all juniors and seniors. Heritage Hall also, they have one freshman, and their freshman is The freshman is number 23, T.J. Williams. He's a freshman. That's the guy that with the ball just passed. He's a center.
Yeah, and he's 6'5". So
yeah, he
hit his growth spurt early.
Yeah, 6'5", freshman.
Looks like Star Spencer is working off in the man D at the beginning of the game, keeping the pressure on the ball as they move around to the right side of the key.
Yeah, Heritage Hall. Heritage Hall, they seem to be moving the ball pretty good. They're coming off a
– Was that a three-second violation? Heritage Hall starting with a full press on the guard as it come down. Makai working the top, and a shot for three from Cedric Brown is missed, and the offensive board is brought back down, and then loose balls picked up by number 45, Rhett Davis from Heritage Hall, down to the other end. Three-point shot is off the mark. Kaleon Johnson with a rebound brings the ball back down the court. Loses the handle, off to the right side of the key. Shot bounces off the rim, back up to the top with Cameron Brown. Down low, the low post. The power move to the basket is off the mark with a layup. Heritage Hall rebound. Kaleon Johnson.
Heritage Hall has hoped to extend their win streak. They won last game. They're 3-6 right now, so they're hoping to capitalize on that and beat the Bobcats here at the Star Spencer. So the first points of the night, 45, Rhett Davis. He's a sophomore. He's 6'3". We'll have him down for 6'3". We'll have to see if he's
some tall shoes, maybe.
Right.
Ball's loose in the back. Yeah, ball's loose in the backcourt. Cameron Brown with the points off the loose ball. Rashad Smith took the ball down the lane. His shot was off the mark. And Roman Welch with the offensive rebound. Another shot by Smith. And Star Spencer recovers and back on offense. Kaleon Johnson works the ball down to the left, down to Cedric Brown. Drives to the basket. And it's off the mark with the offensive rebound by Anderson. And the three-point falls good. Kaleon Johnson. Heritage Hall calls a timeout. 5:13 left in the first quarter. Bobcats 5, Heritage Hall 2.
Seems to be a pretty scrappy game so far. I know in the first quarter, Star Spencer's in a press, and it looks like it's kind of working. We have our starting lineup for Heritage Hall Chargers. Number 1, Roman Welch. Number 11, Rashad Smith. 23, T.J. Williams. 12, Xavier Imbro. And number 45, Rhett Davis. The head coach is Dylan Sullivan. How long has Dylan Sullivan been?
This is his first year at Heritage Hall.
Okay.
He replaced a longtime coach that just stepped down last season. And I think they were they the 23, was that what, class state champions this past season.
Okay. So as the play gets back started, Rashad Smith is going to take the ball out for the Chargers, and they seem to have something set up for the press that Star Spencer's in.
Roman Welch's pass in the backcourt goes out of bounds. Another turnover back to Star Spencer. Looked like the pressure from the press was pretty effective on that last possession.
Kaleon for the drive and the dish. No good. Rashad Smith drives the lane. Looks like he got fouled. You're going to report. That foul is on Makai Gillum. That is his first personal, and it's the first team foul here tonight. The first end of the two is good for Rashad Smith. First one wasn't.
Rhett Davis with another offensive rebound.
Traveling and call. I don't think he can do that, can he?
He's not supposed to carry the ball and walk at the same time.
Okay, all right. In for relief for the Bobcats, number 34, Rayshon Faye. He's also a senior here, Star Spencer. Seems like we have, I'm looking at the roster, it's all juniors and seniors for Star Spencer. I see one freshman on the roster.
With a whistle, another traveling. They turn over to Heritage Hall. The quick inbound to Xavier Imbro. 2 points. 5-5 with 4:20 left in the first quarter. Killian brings it down, passes it along to Makai. Makai has his pocket picked by Xavier Imbro, and he takes it back down for the easy layup.
Timeout. Star Spencer Bobcats, that's going to be a 30-second timeout.
7-5 with 4:04 left in the first quarter.
We didn't announce the Star Spencer starters. We need to get those before we get too far along. Well, Star Spencer starters was number 2, Makai Gellum. Number 4, Cedric Brown. Number 10, Kaleon Johnson. Number 20, Corian Anderson. And 25, Cameron Brown.
From the timeout, we have now Christopher Albertson checks into the game for Star Spencer.
Kaleon Johnson puts up a three, no good. But it's rebounded by Christopher Albertson.
Offensive rebounds quickly given up. Loose ball as they move down the court, and ball's eventually corralled by Kaleon Johnson and brings it back down for Star Spencer. They called a whistle on number 12, Imbro. I think he called that on the floor prior to the shot. It'd be Star Spencer's ball at the baseline.
This foul was on Imbro. That's his first personal, so that's the first team foul for Cassidy Chargers. On the line. In for the Bobcats, number 4, Cedric Brown.
On the inbound, they quickly move the ball around the arc. The shot from the corner is no good. Rebounded by Heritage Hall.
The rebound.
Rhett Davis.
Rhett Davis. That's at least his second or third rebound that I can remember tonight so far. He seems to be putting in work for him under the basket.
And he's got the body to work down low.
Right.
Johnson brings the ball down with light pressure from Rashad Smith.
Kaleon, he's been an integral part of the Star Spencer Bobcat team for about 4 years. I mean, he's a senior, and he's just been kind of quiet, but he silently puts in work.
That's good. That's good. Team. You see that it's paying off. And then Makai Gillum is called for the extra step. Traveling ball back over to Heritage Hall.
Terrell Orange checks in for the Bobcats.
Oh, challenge at the basket and the foul. It was like Xavier Imbro went down a little hard but looks like he'll be okay to take his shots.
That foul's on Rashawn Fay. That's his first and the second team foul. And Xavier Imbro goes to the free throw line. I think I'm liking the way Coach Cudjoe for the Stars, Mr. Bobcats, is doing his subbing. Like he's getting kids in there.
Yeah, keeps the legs fresh.
Yeah. Unlike, Heritage Hall, they just subbed, but it seemed like they have a core four or five that they have.
Yep.
But we'll see how that pays off for them later.
It does pay off. Keep it fresh legs, or right. You got it's a risk reward for sure. Kaleon for three again. He makes
it. Kaleon. 3 points.
Makes the score 8-9 Bobcats.
I think we'll see more Kaleon, you know, more action from him as he settles down, yep. As the game gets settled down. This is the first quarter. 2 minutes left in the first quarter.
Rebound by Gabriel Butler on the way back. Seems deciding which way the ball is going to go. It's a turnover. Back to Heritage Hall. The big freshman at the top of the key works the ball down and kicks it out to Porter Gillespie into the game. And then I think, did he take an extra step? I missed it. The call.
I was just thinking that number 23, a lot of their plays run through the freshman, the big guy.
Everybody looks athletic. Looks like he's got control of his body.
Right, he brings the ball down
for his age.
Mm-hmm. He brings the ball down, and he's at the top of the key, and he makes the first pass. Yep. And he's clogging up the middle right now on defense, so I can see why they're doing that.
Star Spencer looks doing a good job getting the ball in and out through the defense, keeping it moving. Nice screen set there by Cameron Brown. Pass the corner to Cedric Brown. And we got another traveling call. Looks like this officiating crew has been real close and real attuned to traveling tonight.
Well, I think that's good. I mean, as long as they're being fair, you know, and calling everything, and so that lets the players know, like, and the coaches, okay, this will fly or this won't fly. As long as they're consistent.
That's right.
I think everything.
A lot of things, consistency pays off. And keeps the players and the fans satisfied. Oh, the challenge at the basket. Roman Welch taking it to the hole. And Corian Anderson called for the foul. It's going to be two shots for Roman Welch. Third team foul for Star against Star Spencer.
Yeah.
First shot. First shot falls off the bucket. It's critical missing free throws, leaving points on the floor.
Yeah, especially it seemed like it's going to be a close game.
Yeah.
And with 1 minute left in the first quarter, you know, they're trying.
Oh, Johnson all the way to the hole. He draws the foul. This foul on
that foul's on Xavier Imbro. That's his second, and that's two quick fouls in the first quarter. They could come down to something really big in the fourth quarter,
right.
Needing him on the floor. Well, they sub him out, try to save some of those fouls for later. Rashad Smith checks in the game,
and Durwood Loggins for Star Spencer. Less than a minute to go in the first quarter. 10-9 Bobcats. Rashad Smith takes the ball down, kicks it out, back up to the top.
That was a good move.
The freshman off the mark. Star Spencer rebound. And Johnson brings the ball down the right side, and they quickly move it over to the left side. And Makai Gillum loses the handle. A turnover, 34 seconds left in the first quarter. To Heritage Hall. Spencer pressures at the half court. Really looks like Heritage Hall is going to take its time and play to the last shot for the first quarter.
Yeah, Coach Cudgel on the other end, he's really trying to get the students' attention, get the players' attention down there, where he's like he's pacing up and down, but he got their attention.
Yeah. TJ Williams back to the line, the 6'5 freshman. Another point left on the floor by Heritage Hall. That ties the score, 16 seconds left. Heritage Hall still set up in the man defense. Star playing for the last shot of the quarter.
Derwin Loggins puts up. No good.
So at the end of the first quarter, it's 10-10. Star Spencer and Heritage Hall here at the Johnson & Johnson Gymnasium. And we'll take a quick break. We'll be back for the second quarter.
Sounds, it reminds me of some of that Saturday Night Live skit. And we're back.
And we're back. Yeah, a lot of collision during the rebound. I think that's going to be a foul on Star Spencer's Corion Anderson. Second foul of the game on the floor. Be a Heritage Hall's ball.
If you just tuned in with us, it is 19-16. Chargers on top, 4 minutes and 15 seconds left in the second quarter. And we're at Star Spencer High School, Johnston Johnson Fieldhouse.
Gabriel Butler providing a little backcourt pressure to Heritage Hall's Rashad Smith. He takes it down. Short J misses. And
Makai Geller.
Star Spencer did a good job of retransition and getting a quick 2 points.
That was Gabriel Butler. I'm sorry. That was Gabriel Butler.
There he goes. Another good chance. Good show of Star Spencer defensive pressure down on the board. And as Terrence Brown, Heritage Hall, call for the reach-in down there on the mid-post.
Now here comes the substitution.
Rhett Davis is subbed out in for
It seems like Heritage Hall, they wasn't subbing a lot at first, but yeah. Now it seems like they're starting to sub.
Then we get Britt Mollerby. 6'2", Malerb.
Yep, Malerb.
Another turnover, Heritage Hall.
TJ Williams checks back in for Heritage Hall. I guess coach was just giving him a breather. I thought maybe he would have sat him down for the rest of the, rest of the, you know, half.
Yeah. The hand of Roman Welch just got caught in underneath Leon's for another foul. Seems like Heritage Hall is aggressive at the pass and getting those fouls right there on the floor. 6'5" freshman with the rebound. Bringing it down the court. He's going to take it all the way to the basket. That was a foul on.
That was on Derwin Loggins.
Derwin Loggins. That was a good challenge. I thought that.
Yeah, that's his second foul.
Yep. That it could have gone either way.
Star Spencer seems to be putting TJ Williams on the line because this is not his first, second, or third time going to the line.
Yep.
I mean, I guess he's handling the ball, but
he's leaving some points on the floor.
Well, I was just about to say he hasn't really missed. He missed that time, but yep. He hasn't really missed. So they want to stop putting him on the line. Derwin Loggins with the rebound.
Oh.
That could have been bad.
I think that he thought he was going to jump.
That could have been bad. You know, sometimes but you want all the players to be safe.
Yep. That is a scary feeling coming down, and you know your feet are not going to be underneath you.
Right.
And you got number Britt Mollerbury to the line. 2.5 minutes left in the second quarter. It's a one-point game. Bobcats 18, Heritage Hall 19.
Yeah, that was Cameron Brown that went airborne like that. That's his first foul. He's been kind of laying low so far in this game, but coach been subbing him in and out. He's up for three. No good.
Roman Welch now at the point with TJ Williams on the bench. Picks up his dribble, has to lay it off to Rashad Smith.
That foul's on Derwin Loggins. That's his third.
Yeah, he's going to have some trouble in the second half.
Yeah, I wonder if the coach will let him play since we only have 2 minutes. He seems to have been a good part of the, you know, clogging up the middle.
Yeah.
Oh, coach is sitting him down.
Yeah, three fouls. They bring in
Rashawn Fay.
Rashawn Fay, the senior. Heritage Hall is going to try a little two-man trap on the backcourt. Star Spencer works his way out. Kaleon Johnson brings it down, takes it to the hole, and scores.
I told you, Kaleon Johnson. He's quiet, but he makes his presence known.
He does. We've been saying his name quite a bit in this first half. That one just came out of his hands heavy
right.
From Rashad Smith.
And Rashawn just happened to be the right place, right time. I think that may be his first rebound of the night.
Yep.
Gabriel Butler puts it up. Star Smith is finding a way to make their own shots. You know, like they're moving without the ball. They seem to be good ball movement.
Yep.
Like Heritage Hall seems to do a lot of dribbling.
Oh, that could have gone either way.
Right.
That was a good challenge to the basket.
He got him with the body, so maybe that's more of what it is. And that was on Rashawn Fay. That's his second personal.
We find TJ Williams back at the line. Rolls out. Heritage Hall with a 1-point lead with a minute left in the second half, 21-20. Johnson over to Butler. Butler to Cedric Brown. Back to Johnson.
Kaleon
showing some glass, some skill on the glass. 35 seconds left in the half. Ball ends up on his foot, and we get a backcourt. He looked a little bit confused, but it definitely rolled off his foot.
Right.
On the offensive player's foot. Right.
Whose foot did that roll off of?
It looked like it rolled off the Heritage Hall player. And we got into the new into the game, Porter Gillespie with the three from the corner.
All right, we're down to about 15 seconds left in this half.
Oh. Another offensive board. Johnson with the ball on the top. So we go to halftime, 24-22 Chargers. So it was a pretty exciting first half, back and forth. And I think we're about right where we started.
Yeah, I mean, we're going to start basically even. So, it means it's a good game. I think what it is Star Spencer, they have one person in foul trouble, which is Derwin Loggins. He has three. And Heritage Hall, they don't have anybody necessarily in foul trouble. Xavier Imbro, he has two. I believe the high point man for Star Spencer is Kaleon Johnson. I don't have the numbers with me right now, but he's probably the high point man. And then who's the – it's probably TJ Williams.
I think so.
For the Chargers. the high point person for them.
And really saw the strong point for Star Spencer in the first half was the movement towards the basket, movement of the ball around the key. And then for Heritage Hall, they really drove to the basket well, but then I think once they did draw fouls, I think their field goal percentage was a little bit lower than what they were hoping for.
Right.
Their free throw percentage was a little bit lower.
Right. Star Spencer, they have, like I was talking about their defense. Their defense, whenever Heritage Hall goes to the lane, it's at least three white jerseys from Star Spencer that's, you know, clogging up the middle, contesting the shots.
Yep.
Now, all of them may not be good contesting because they're Heritage Hall seems to be going to the foul line a lot. But, you know, they're being contested. And then on this end, Star Spencer seems to be doing their thing on offense, you know?
Yep.
And it seems like they're creating their own shots. And they're missing shots, which is giving Heritage Hall the chance to rebound.
Right.
You know, so it doesn't seem like Heritage Hall is doing a whole bunch of banging around in the paint to get the rebound. It just seems like they're in the right place at the right time, or Star Spencer is not rebounding offensive rebounds.
Right.
It could be that too. But we're at 24-22, and the Chargers are winning. It is halftime. after checking the books, I was right about Star Spencer, that Kaleon is the high point man. He has 12. But Heritage Hall, they seem to be sharing the ball pretty evenly. So you have one person with 7 points, another one with 6. So they seem to be sharing the ball pretty well. We're going to start the second half. Star Spencer's ball.
So we got Butler, Gilliam, Johnson, Cameron Brown, and Corian Anderson on the floor for Star Spencer to start out the third quarter. Yeah. Heritage Hall's Roman Welch, Rhett Davis, Xavier Imbro, Rashad Smith, and TJ Williams. Shots off the mark. Heritage Hall takes over. Working it back to the basket. Challenged.
Heritage Hall decides to come in hot. Rashad Smith, 2 points. First possession of the second half. Not only is Heritage Hall running the offense through number 23, also running defense because he's at the top.
Stop working it. Ball's out of play. Back to Heritage Hall. A really tight pass down the baseline.
Makai Davis, number 2 for Star Spencer. He's pretty scrappy. I'm looking at him. He's kind of all over the place. Not in a bad way, but he's always around the ball. You know, he's making a way to get open, just like now. And he puts it up. Bang.
Drains it off the glass.
Off the glass. 3 points. Makai Gilliam. And just like right there, that defense. He's making it known.
They're really wanting to put the pressure on in the start of the second half, make it difficult for Heritage Hall to move the ball down the court. They break the press.
And that was again Rashad Smith
again taking it all the way to the hole.
Yeah. So far, he has the only points of this half for the Chargers. And correct that, Xavier Imbro.
Take that.
Timeout.
Take the steal coast to coast. It's a good time for a timeout for Star Spencer to catch the breath and break the rhythm that Heritage Hall had built pretty quick.
Right.
This is a quick jump for the the 2 point to a 5 point lead for Heritage Hall here in the third quarter.
Star Spencer is scheduled to be here tomorrow. We have another game here tomorrow. I can't think who we're playing. I have to look at the schedule, but that depends on what the weather's going to be like. And the Chargers, they have a game on the 12th versus Harding Charter Prep. So this is a good game. It's shaping up to be a good game. So whoever wins this is going to – oh, they're on the ground. And – timeout. That was a smart timeout by this coach. I don't want to call him a rookie coach because I don't know where he was.
I think he was a longtime assistant in Heritage Hall.
Oh, okay. But yeah. Is this the first time?
This is his first time as the head coach.
Okay. So is it safe to call him a rookie coach? I don't want to sound disrespectful.
Rookie head coach.
Okay. Yeah. Rookie head coach. And that was actually a heads up play. They called the timeout right there when they were, you know, both vying for the ball.
Yeah. And Makai Gilliam again taking the ball to the basket. Playing scrappy, even though he didn't sink the bucket, he did catch the defense's attention.
Right. other than Coach Sullivan on the Chargers, I see the other assistant coaches in there too, making some plays. Well, not making some plays, but talking to the players. I see Coach Nash, he's assistant coach, along with Hamilton Jr. No, what's his first name? Chris Hamilton.
Looks like he's a 2015 grad of Heritage Hall.
Okay.
Megan Mackay working point. He gets the ball down low.
He was blocked.
Corian Anderson's blocked. Oh. And then a quick steal.
Gabriel Butler.
And put the basket up with Butler.
Yeah, Star Spencer, they're in this press, and it's working for him. It worked for him the first half. He went on by him. He got a little tired.
Oh, the reach off his face. And the
so
steal.
Is that, so is that good defense?
I think
good
it's
offense?
A steal. We're going yeah. Mackay for three off the back of the rim. Ooh.
Oh.
Yeah, definitely came down on his back a little bit.
Yeah, that foul's on Corian Butler. That's his third. And the Chargers, they got one more assistant coach down there. What's his name down there?
Kareem Hakeem.
Kareem Hakeem.
Just rolls off the
yeah, coach,
back
coach
of the
Hakeem,
mouth.
Right. Oh, we have an offensive foul on number one, Roman Welch. That's his second. And for the Bobcats, you have Coach Cudjoe and then one assistant coach, Harold Smith. Coach Smith, he's also the football coach for the Star Spencer Bobcats, but he's the assistant coach for the boys' basketball.
That's what I like about high school sports is that especially as a coach, you get a chance to spread out, in many cases, multiple sports. Because at this level is the time when you enjoy working with the kids
right.
and developing them as athletes and as young adults. Rashad Smith,
he seems like he's come alive this quarter. Like he's doing it. He missed this one, but he made the previous ones.
Oh, almost got the bucket. This is Gabe Butler, the foul called on Jamuri Hayworth. It's the first time that we called his name tonight. Oh, correction, that's Porter Gillespie. .420 left in the third quarter, 3-point lead, Heritage Hall, with Gabriel Butler at the line. His first shot goes
short.
Off the front of the
yeah.
rim.
Probably should try to put a little bit more air under it. As I say, to flick the wrist.
Ah. The second one's off the mark. There's 2 points left on the floor. Star Spencer gets the ball back.
Kayleon Johnson with the rebound.
Working. Offense covers his own shot.
Oh, he almost traveled.
And then ball gets out to T.J. Williams, the freshman. 6'5 from Heritage Hall.
So the second half, Rashad Smith seems to be taking control for the Chargers. And then he passes off. So, and
oh, the three from Porter Gillespie.
Porter Gillespie. Did he play the first
I think
half?
He was in for just a little bit.
Okay. So he's they're saying, like, put me in, coach. He should have been, maybe should have been in the first half.
Yeah. Star still moving the ball around well around the perimeter, waiting for the seam to open up to drive to the basket. With ball gets loose again. They tie it up. Kellyon recovers it before they can call a foul or a jump ball. Let's see. Gabe Butler's called for
carry.
The carry. It's unfortunate to get your momentum going, and sometimes the ball just sticks to your hand.
Heritage Hall is playing.
Cameron Brown takes a seat.
Heritage Hall is playing aggressive this quarter so far, and he's opened up the lead to 6 points. It was just 2 points at the quarter. I mean, at the half. I know 6 points doesn't seem like a lot, but it could get to be a lot, you know.
Yeah. So you want the lead to be manageable, or the
right,
deficit to be manageable.
Because if they go one more three, And then that's 9 points.
Yep, and that's a three-possession game.
Right. And again, it seemed like the Bobcats had that momentum taken away.
Yes, Spencer called for the walk. Turnover back to Heritage Hall. Rashad Smith at the point.
Right.
Brings it down over the line. Johnson on defense, still playing man-to-man. Xavier Imbro to the bucket is no good.
Gillespie gets the ball.
Gillespie with offensive rebounds has been key tonight. Rhett Davis go to the line for two.
That foul is on 24 Derwin Loggins. That is his fourth. This is fourth foul. So he's going to be playing.
Definitely going to be a balance for risk-reward to leave him in the game.
Right.
Coach Goodjoe's already sending somebody to the table to check in.
Rhett Davis. The first in.
Got the shooter's roll on the first shot.
Yeah, Derwin Loggins reluctantly leaves the game. He listened to his coach, obviously, but he wants to stay in. But I think it's, like you're saying, it's the risk-reward. He got one foul. And it's a 7-point game, 8-point game, and probably need him later.
Yeah. T.J. Williams' shot misses after the turnover. Gabriel Butler takes it back down the court. Moving the ball a little bit. Star Spencer seems to be driving a little bit more to the hole, a little bit more aggressive than they were in the first half, building a little bit of sense of urgency. And T.J. Williams puts the bucket back up. Now a 10-point lead with a minute 50 left in the third quarter.
Yeah,
Star Spencer calls a timeout.
Trying to keep things manageable. That 7-point game is now a 10-point game.
Yep.
Star Smith is fine. It's just 10 points. You know, they just have to Coach Cudjoe, he'll talk to him. He'll figure a way to get, to close the gap.
Yep. It's a balance of patience and aggressiveness. You can't be too aggressive, and then that'll backfire on you and leave you open to turnovers and
right. Missed
opportunities.
But looking down the bench, number 23 for Heritage Hall, T.J. Williams, he hasn't been out the game much. And I'm seeing he's down there. He's very winded. He's tired. So that may not work in their favor in the fourth quarter when you need, just like we was talking about how Star Spencer, they're substituting, keeping those fresh legs in.
And on the floor for Heritage Hall, you got Gillespie, Smith, Davis, Williams, Imbro, and I think that was Star Spencer. Still moving the ball around really well. Johnson puts it on the floor and then passes it off to Corin Anderson back up to
Seems like Star Spencer, they're being less aggressive these last two minutes. They're waiting for an open.
Told him slow. Yeah, he took his time getting to the basket there. And drew the foul.
That was foul. That was on T.J. Williams. That's his first personal the whole game.
Wow.
This is his first foul.
He's got a lot of minutes for.
But I wonder, does that mean he's getting tired?
Yeah.
He hasn't had any fouls the whole game. And now you get one, and we're talking about that. We see that he's winded. Gabriel Butler goes to the line. He hits the second one.
Gillespie for three.
He overshot that one.
With Heritage Hall with the offensive rebound. Kaylee Johnson with a foul. That'll send Xavier Imbro to the line to shoot two.
Speaking of first fouls, that's Kaylee's first foul.
Minute 5 left in the third. Nine-point lead for Heritage Hall.
One minute left in the third quarter.
Star Spencer still handling the ball fairly well. A couple times it's been on the floor. 45 seconds left in the quarter. Johnson slows it down. It's like Heritage Hall is playing a little bit softer, man. Letting Star Spencer move the ball around the perimeter. And only challenging them when they move towards the basket. Makai lost the handle. Correction, Gabriel Butler lost the handle. And it was a Star Spencer, correction, of the turnover to Heritage Hall. Shot Smith takes the ball down the court. 25 seconds left in the quarter. Protecting a 10-point lead for Heritage Hall. T.J. Smith loses the hand. T.J. Williams loses the handle, and there's a turnover.
Puts it up for three. No good. And five seconds left in this quarter.
Yeah, like that rolled right off of Corian Anderson's leg and out of bounds back to Heritage Hall. And brings us to the end of the third quarter. 10-point lead for Heritage Hall, 38-28.
So what are the keys that Star Spencer going to have to do to get back in the game?
They're going to have to start moving to the basket and getting those shots. It seems like that those lanes have closed up that they were using in the first half. Really, they've only scored – they only scored – was it 2 points in the – 4 points in the third quarter. And so those lanes, as Heritage Hall has done a good job of shutting down those shooting lanes and preventing those buckets to fall.
Yeah, Heritage Hall seemed to have studied them and then made the changes at halftime, like I said, to shut them down. So now Star Spencer, they're tasked. Coach Cudjo and the Star Spencer Bobcats, they're tasked with making those changes and now closing the gap.
Yep, they got to stop Heritage Hall from adding to their lead and then at the same time hold the ball and score some points. 8 minutes to play, fourth quarter, 38-28. Heritage Hall over Star Spencer Bobcats. The Johnson & Johnson Fieldhouse in Spencer, Oklahoma.
Coming up next, we have the Heritage Hall Charger Girls versus the Star Spencer Lady Bobcats.
It's like Rashad Smith did a good job of losing his man across the key. His three-point shot is no good. Gabriel Butler's drive to the basket falls off the front of the rim. And a quick break. T.J. Williams to the hole is no good, but the foul is called. It'll send him to the line for two shots. That foul looks like it was called on Makai Gillum.
That's his third.
So starting to have to see a little bit of strategy on playing time with a couple of the Star Spencer players looking at some foul trouble potentially with 7.5 minutes left in the fourth. Gillespie is out for Heritage Hall. And that brings Roman Welch back in the game. T.J. Williams, two shots are good. It's 40-28, Heritage Hall. With a stoppage of play. Not sure why we had that stoppage, but they stopped the game and gave the ball back to Spencer. Gabriel Butler drives, kicks it out. The ball is shot is way off. Let's get that Keyline jumping across the line to bring the ball back. Roman Welch working the point. T.J. Williams down to Rhett Davis. Back out. Pump shots, works in, gets trapped against the baseline.
There it's you go. Star Spencer.
Intercepted, yeah. But it steps
out.
Out
of bounds.
Makai Gillen's showing some hustle.
Star Spencer got to get that defense back to what they had in the first quarter where they were attacking the ball. Xavier Imbro takes the ball out from the corner. That was intercepted by Star Spencer. And so,
it's a good block.
Makai Gellum, again, he seems to be everywhere right now. He's like, he's making a lot of good moves. We just need to, Star Spencer needs to,
there we go, from the baseline.
Corian Anderson.
With Heritage Hall's lead still at 10, they're really going to have to do some work to get back in this game. Ball gets inside the top of the key with a whistle.
And travel.
Six minutes left in the fourth, 40-30. Heritage Hall over Star Spencer Bobcats. Johnson brings around to the left side.
Right.
Works it back. Still moving the ball around the perimeter really well. Johnson moves that out to Butler. Butler to the hole, and a foul for two shots. We'll go to the line.
That foul's on Xavier Imbro. This is third. I assume the coach would keep him in with 5 minutes left.
5 minutes with a 10-point lead. I think the risk-reward is to leave him in the game, I think,
right,
for the more of the reward. Butler's first free throw is off the back of the rim. The second falls in, 32-40.
Yeah, Butler seems – he's one for four on free throws because the first two, remember, he went off the front end and off the side.
Yep.
The game could be a lot closer if Star Spencer would make their free throws. Rashad Smith. We said his name a lot this half.
Yeah, he's been a key player for Heritage Hall.
And opening the game up.
Running the point guard. They moved T.J. Williams more down to a high post in their offense and relied more on Rashad Smith as the
timeout. Point guard. Timeout, Star Spencer Bobcats. With it being an 11-point game, do you see Heritage Hall keeping their foot on the gas or slowing it down?
It seemed like the way they've been coached the entire game that I think they will keep playing hard. And you see lots of times teams will get in trouble and they take the foot off the gas, that they'll break the momentum and give an opportunity for their opponent to sneak back into the game. Butler takes it all around, hands it off to Makai Gillum for three. Fall right under the 5-minute point in the fourth quarter.
They need about two more of those. Two more of those 3 points, and the game would be a lot closer. It'll make for an interesting end of the game.
It will. Still the pressure on the bringing the ball. It's Rashad Smith again driving to the hole for another 2 points.
Yeah.
Keeps the lead at 10. 4.5 minutes to go. Butler to Johnson for three. Butler and Smith combined for the rebound. TJ Williams from the corner for three. Falls short, and then we have a whistle on the rebound. Rhett Davis called for the foul. B-Star Spencer Ball with 4 minutes, 4 seconds left. Durwood Loggins. Yeah, it's still a lot of game left. Durwood Loggins is back in.
Yeah, it's still a lot of game. I think, you know, with 10 points, you can coach a win, you know, but I think Star Spencer, they've used a good share of their timeout, so they may not be able to have call a timeout. And Kaylion Johnson goes, I don't know if is this basket going to count?
Yeah, they count the basket.
Counts the basket for Kaylion Johnson. It's going to be one shot. Who was that foul on? I missed that.
I missed it. Number 11.
That was Rashad Smith.
Heritage Hall breaks the press. With Roman Welch to the bucket, his shot was off the mark, but the foul was called. Is that foul called on
Cameron Brown?
Cameron
25.
Brown.
That's his second personal.
With Roman Welch at the line, just stretch the lead back out. 8 points.
Though he made that one, Heritage Hall has missed their share of free
they
throws.
They have
too.
Missed a good share of the free throws.
But he made both of those.
Makes it when it counts. The 9-point lead, 3:45 left in the fourth.
What does it say? It's not how many you hit, it's when you hit them.
That's right. Johnson moves in. And the shot goes over the backboard. Star Spencer still looking to keep the pressure on Heritage Hall. And gets the steal on the inbound. Gabe Butler showing the hustle, not giving up on the game. Gilliam moves it around to Cameron Brown and takes the shot at the three.
That's what I was talking about. Star Spencer, they're shooting, but they're no offensive rebounds. I don't see any white jerseys under the basket.
Not on the basket, yep.
For offensive rebounds.
It could be showing some signs of fatigue. Star Spencer's been playing man defense the entire game. That'll wear your legs,
yeah.
Wear on your legs pretty good. Welch works it back, loses the handle, stolen.
Kaylion Johnson goes. Ah.
Johnson draws the foul, block, two shots. That was a good steal. It looked like that was a steal by Gabriel Butler to give Johnson the chance to come back. Take the shot and go to line.
Yeah, that foul was on Roman Welch. That's his third personal. It seemed like Heritage Hall, their strategy worked, keeping the players in.
Yep.
Well, you said the risk reward of Star Spencer's, you know, changing.
There's your offensive rebound. Another steal off the offensive board. Butler with the ball, kicks it back out to the top. There's the three.
Makai Gillum, 3 points.
Cuts the lead to five.
It's a 5-point game.
2 minutes and 15 seconds left, a foul on the ball.
and that was a foul on Makai Gillen. Okay. That's his fourth. So we're getting close to that.
Heritage Hall calls a timeout. 30-second timeout.
-46-41 with 2 minutes left.
Yep, just over 2 minutes left in the game.
Heritage Hall is on top by 5 points.
The Star Spencer has a glimmer and a chance, I see, as the momentum has shifted here in the last 30 seconds of the game.
Yeah, a 5-point deficit. That's not horrible. With 2 minutes left, five points.
They got the threes to fall. And are now working hard on defense and the offensive boards.
All right, so they put Derwin Loggins back in. He has 4 fouls. So we're going to see how that's going to work out this last 2 minutes.
The long inbound pass.
And
it's off the mark, kicks it out. That's going to be a Star Spencer ball.
Star Spencer ball.
Rhett Davis thought he had somebody out there to tip the ball out to, but there was no one home. On the inbound, the pressure coming up on Heritage Hall. They're still letting Star Spencer, bring the ball down.
I see T.J. Williams is covering Kaleon Johnson because Kaleon Johnson is the high point man.
Yeah.
You see how Kaleon is out there on the wing, and Williams is covering him.
And Star Spencer is done a good job of.
Butler gets his own variety. Rebound. And Gillum
sinks the three. Round a 2-point game.
2-point game. Here we go.
Shai Smith brings the ball down, kicks it out to
number 12,
Embro.
Rashad Buck, he eyes the basket. He's waiting on the play to develop. And here he goes. He puts it up.
And he sinks the three. Minute 13 left in the fourth.
Takes it back to a 5-point game.
Gillum moves her all around. Butler to the hole, draws the foul. We go under just a minute to play, 1 minute to play in the fourth.
That foul is on Roman Welch. That's his fourth. Now we're getting close. I assume, coaches, anybody that's they're going to be playing right now, nobody's going to be subbed. These five that we have in right here, these team are going to stay.
These are the ones to make.
Right.
And
Gabriel Butler, he made that one. He missed those. Now he's 2 for 5.
Yep.
Let's see if he can go 3 for 6 and he'll be 500 on the night. They're okay.
There we go.
Yeah, now how many you hit is when you hit them. 3-point game, 1 minute left.
It's almost time for Star Spencer to think about fouling. I think they do have some fouls to give for the bonus. Don't want to use a whole lot of clock. T.J. Williams to the basket from the baseline. 2 points. 40 seconds left to play. 51-46, Heritage Hall. Gillum off the mark for three. Offensive rebound.
That was Corey Anderson.
Anderson. 20 seconds. We're going to have to.
I think they're taking a lot of time.
There's too much time.
And one.
With Xavier Embro bringing the ball back down.
Yeah, that foul was on Cameron Brown.
13 seconds left in the fourth.
That was on 25. Cameron Brown, this is third personal. 13 seconds left.
May seal the deal for Heritage Hall.
7-point game.
Oh! Roman Welch. It's called for the block.
That's his fifth personal.
Two shots.
Yeah, that's Roman's fifth personal.
And so he had a tough game.
Well,
hit a good game.
Yeah. He had one the whole first half, and then he got 4 quick ones right here. you know, he started. He's probably trying to make something happen. And he's obviously an integral part of the team.
And with 10 seconds left, it's not a bad time to use your last foul.
Makai Gillum. Now it seems like after he missed those first two, like he's hot on the free throws. Now he's dialed in. But it may be a little too late.
Then you got a foul. At least save some time.
Right. That foul's on Makai Gillum. That's his fifth personal. So they'll wait for Coach Cudjoe to substitute. Star Spencer boys will be in action again tomorrow, weather pending, here at the Johnson Johnson Fieldhouse. And Heritage Hall Chargers, they will be in action on the 12th versus Harding Charter Prep. Rashawn Smith, he came alive this quarter.
He had a great second half.
Yeah, he had a great second half.
And a strong fourth quarter. And that'll do it. Heritage Hall Chargers 54, Spencer Bobcats 48.
Check 1-2.
Check 1-2.
The starting lineup for the Star Spangled Bobcats. Number 0, Candace Brady. Number 1, Quinaya Brown. Number 3, Asia Carter. Number 12, Kira Traylor. And number 20, Kendall Rowland.
And the Heritage Hall starting lineup is Sophia LeClaire, Lainey Portman, Marley Moore, Reagan Creamer, and Coral Grimmett.
That Reagan is Creamer.
Creamer. Yeah. Creamer. Creamer.
Again, Star Spencer. They seem their starting lineup. It's kind of spread out. I see a sophomore. Let me see. One freshman. A sophomore and a couple of seniors. So it's kind of balanced.
And the Heritage Hall starting lineup's 3 seniors and 2 freshmen.
Okay. Isaac Carter is going to do the tip for the Bobcats. Marley Moore is going to do the tip for the Chargers.
Heritage Hall wins the tip.
The head coach for the Chargers is Olivia Nixon. And assistant coaches Crystal Pickron and Nick Traylor.
Work it into the post. Lose the handle and recover the ball. Back down under the basket. Ball gets on the floor and a jump ball is called.
It's not often you see girls get on the ground and hustle for the ball, you know, just scrap for the ball like that. I'm glad to see it.
First back it goes to Star Spencer.
Quinaya Brown.
Quinaya Brown, yep.
Yeah, the head coach for the Star Spencer Bobcats is Jamie Caldwell, assistants Keisha Kearney and Tamara Shaver.
Lainey Portman takes it to the hole, and Star Spencer rebound with Asia Carter bringing the ball back down for Star Spencer. Offensive rebound doesn't pay a dividend, but a quick steal by Asia Carter puts the ball up off the back of the glass. Heritage Hall brings the ball down with a Reagan Creamer. 3-point shot by...
Oh, she slid out of bounds.
Marley Moore is no good. Ball. A lot of hustle in the beginning of the first quarter.
Candace Brady.
Minute and a half in the first quarter. Bobcats 2, Heritage Hall 0. To the glass and the whistle. That'll send number 3, Lainey Portman, to the line for 2 shots. Lainey Portman puts the Chargers on the board.
My head was down. I was doing something else. Who was that foul on?
I missed it, too.
Okay.
Kenia Brown at point. Some big passes across the boundary. Goes out of bounds as a turnover back to Heritage Hall. The 3-point from Sophie LeClaire falls short. And the rebound is Asia Carter is corrals it in. A block called on Lainey Portman. called on the floor. It'll be Star Spencer's ball on the baseline under the basket.
Isaac Carter gets the inbound pass. Bernardi Brown drives the lane.
She had a good. She had a perfect crease to move through and took advantage of the room that Heritage Hall gave her.
Yeah. Aja Carter, she's at the top on the defense for the Bobcats. She's very athletic. She's been here before. She's a senior. And she's getting that rebound just
yeah,
like that.
Yeah, she's tough on rebound. She had a good block out.
Yeah.
Pulled the ball in nicely.
She's an all-around athlete. You should see her throw a football. People have asked when we saw her out just toss the football, like, why are you not our quarterback? No, she can throw. She can move in the pocket too. Kira Trailer goes up. Bernardi Brown.
She's blocked by Sophia Leclerc. Ball's out of bounds to Star Spencer.
Star Spencer ball.
5 minutes into the – or 3 minutes into the first quarter, 4-2 Bobcats. Inbound play out to Asia Carter. That was a good pass.
A traveling
travel. I thought she had a good rhythm to the basket.
Yeah.
So, they get tripped over each other, and it's
Bobcat
out of bounds to the Bobcats. On that possession, looked like Heritage Hall just didn't have time or didn't take the time to set up their offense, and gave the ball away.
Kanaya to Aja.
It was a very nice work around the
Aja
press.
To Candace.
Down on the
Candace to Kendall
floor
and over the basket. The ball's over the basket, so it's going to be Heritage Hall ball. Substitute for the Bobcats. In for the Bobcats, Taisha Walker. Aja Carter.
She has a good nose for rebounds. Walker at the top. Passes it off to Kendall Rowland. The ball then stolen by Marley Moore from Heritage Hall. It's a quick transition. She took it all the way to the hole herself.
Did you see that spin move?
She did.
Tasia Walker's bringing the ball up for the Bobcats. She's just waiting for their play to develop. Candace Brady goes with
off
two.
Off the high glass.
6-4 Bobcats. Under 4 minutes to play.
That was Heritage Hall's first offensive board, and it's called the foul, sending Lainey Portman, number 3, to the line. It was Kanaya Brown, I think, was her first foul.
Yes, Kanaya Brown's first foul.
First shot rolls out of the rim.
Lainey Portman, she makes both of those. Tasia Walker brings it up the court.
That was a good pass on the baseline.
Got his sister, Candace Brady.
Got an offensive board, got a good block by Star Spencer. They transition back.
Quinaya Brown.
Very nice move to the basket from the senior.
Marley Moore, she goes from coast to coast. She didn't make it, but Lainey Portman. She seems to be a monster on these offensive rebounds.
Sophia LeClaire with a steal, and Taisha Walker steps in and gives her a foul as she tries to transition back to offense. It seems like both teams are trying to get to the basket as quick as possible in this last couple minutes.
Yeah, they're playing aggressive. Of the quarter, they're both playing aggressive, which is great. Which is going to mean we're going to have a good game.
Good game.
So, Spencer Bobcats 10, Heritage Hall 5.
Yeah, we look at all of a sudden with 2 minutes and 45 seconds left in the first quarter, the Star Spencer's doubled up on Heritage Hall right now.
Right.
Let me see the first time Coral Grimmett to the line for two shots.
I believe that foul's on number 12. Is that what they call that?
I think so. Kira Trailer,
that's their first. Coral Grimmett goes, yeah. She's a freshman. Is she the lone freshman starter? You said it was one? Yeah, I believe she's the lone freshman starter for Heritage Hall.
Anna Walker in the game has the ball roll court off her leg.
Oh, the referee. The
we have
refs
a discussion.
Conferring.
We got one calling a backcourt violation, the other one calling a tip. Let's see what they come up. As they decide that it's a backcourt violation on Star Spencer, we'll turn the ball over to Heritage Hall.
Yeah, the referees, I have their names. I must have moved the paper. But the referees, they're conferring with each other. They worked it out. Taysha Walker brings the ball up, and the ball
she
goes
loses
out.
The handle of tips.
This is the Bobcat ball. Taysha Walker takes the ball out. She gets it to Aja Carter. Aja's in the corner. She's waiting on the play to develop. She's just kind of looking to see. Kendra Rowland has the ball in the corner, passes it to Aja Carter. She thinks about driving the baseline, but she decides to put it up. No good. But they're fighting for the offensive rebound.
She took long J and then was right in between and saw that window to take the shot. And then the foul off the offensive rebound will send Kenaya Brown to the line for two.
That foul was on Coral Grimmett. That's her first. So, Spencer, they haven't really been to the free throw line yet so much. But they have to hit the ones that when they do get there.
They have the opportunity.
Reagan Kramer comes flying in for that rebound. Did you see that?
That's aggressive rebounding. And the pass goes long to the corner. And the three-point attempt by Marley Moore is off the mark.
Heritage Hall, they're playing very aggressive, but in a good way.
Yeah.
In a good way.
It's very, very clean basketball, but a good, clean.
2 points by Marley Moore.
Aggressive basketball. Ties the game with a minute 20 left in the first quarter. 10-10 is the score.
Taisha Walker goes up for two. She did not make that, and the ball is out. The ball stays here, Bobcat ball.
Keeping the man defense, the lofted pass, to the post is intercepted, broken up.
1 minute left, 10-10. Wow.
It's like
she got ahead of herself.
Kendall Rowland just drug her feet just a little bit, and she changed directions and picked up her dribble. Fifty-one seconds left in the fourth. 10-10. The Heritage Hall and Spencer Bobcats.
Aja Carter.
That was a good interception. She brings it down, sets it up on the right side.
For three.
Sinks the three.
Aja Carter.
So Heritage Hall now slowing the pace of play up. Working towards the end of the quarter.
There seems to be still have their foot on the gas.
It's a good give and go. Layups, no good. Another offensive rebound. This is good. That was really, really good defense by Kendall Rowland. You saw that her hands went straight up
right. And
intercept the ball. There was no chance that she was going to commit the foul.
Kendall Rowland.
Under the basket.
She is a junior. She is a second-generation Bobcat athlete. Both her parents went to Star Spencer. Her mom played basketball. So she knows the game.
That was a good first quarter.
At the end of first, Star Spencer Bobcats 13, Heritage Hall Chargers 10.
And that's what I really appreciate about Star Spencer. There's so much heritage families and the different generations that have attended Star Spencer.
Mm-hmm. Star Spencer has a rich tradition with parents and grandparents, you know, second and third generation families that go here, they live in the neighborhood, or they may not live in the same neighborhood, but still live here. And they want their children to graduate from here just like
Spencer
they
home,
did.
A lot of pride, a lot of heritage
right.
In Spencer in general.
Right now we're looking at head coach Olivia Nixon for the Chargers. She's talking to the team. What do you think she's saying to them?
I think that they want to control the ball a little bit more. They get down in the paint, seem to lose the handle a little bit. That's hurting them, but it still speaks to the effectiveness of the Star Spencer defense that is keeping their hands up, keeping their hands near the ball, and disrupting the play down low for Heritage Hall under the basket.
Right. I think Aisha Carter is about to heat up, like she's warming up, and she's starting to get loose. I think they need to kind of get a handle on that. It's 13-10, so it's only the start of the second quarter, so it's a lot of game left, but I think they want to keep that in check before she gets
right.
too hot.
Yeah. The art of the inbound defense is important, and like Taisha Walker's perfected that as she tipped, she rejected the throw-in on the second quarter inbound pass and got the rebound.
Lainey Portman, that was actually a good move to the basket, that spin move that she just made. It just didn't work out for her. And again, with that Euro step,
yep,
I got it this time.
It.
Quinaya Brown.
Makes the score 15-10 early in the second quarter. Star Spencer leads. Pass into the low post to Lainey Portman. Results in a foul that was called number one. Kanaya Brown, that's her first personal foul, first team foul of the second quarter.
That foul was on who?
Kanaya Brown.
Oh, that's her second personal foul.
Portman's first shot is off the mark. They'll leave her one shot left. Star Spencer adjusts their alignment in the lane. And rebounds the second missed free throw. Two points left on the floor by Heritage Hall. Kanaya to the hole. The backhanded backdoor layup is good.
Right.
And
Lainey Portman.
Quick answer by Heritage Hall. And the steal off the inbound. That was Marley Moore stealing, hustle on the inbound. The loose ball keeps bouncing around where the whistle. There's a foul on the floor. The foul's called on Coral Grimmett.
That is her second personal. In for the Bobcats, Corinthia Colbert checks in.
That's the first time seeing her in the game tonight.
Yeah.
Heritage Hall with a quick steal.
Marley Moore.
And the easy layup. Marley Moore has been in the defense and in the backcourt making trouble for Star Spencer in the second quarter.
Yeah, but the coach needs to get that sub in that she has in there before Coral Grimmett gets a third foul.
Yeah, it'd be.
In this second quarter. And Coral, she's in the middle. So she's important to the defense.
Yep.
And they're probably going to need her. Looking at this schedule, they lost to Bishop McGinnis their last game. It was 3 points. It was a close game. So Heritage Halls, you would think that they would want to try to win this game just to kind of turn around and have some
absolutely
momentum.
Absolutely, because the momentum, they're coming off that lost three games in a row.
Yeah, before they play Harding Charter Prep on the 12th. Looked like they lost their first game, but then they won four straight.
Four straight, yeah.
But now they lost three straight, so they're trying to get back on the winning side.
Yeah, they're trying to keep from being streaky.
Right.
We got another offensive rebound from Heritage Hall. Elaney Portman working the point, works it over to the baseline, and the 3 points falls in for
Elaney Portman.
Elaney Portman, yeah. We
said her name a few times already. That ties the game, 17-17, with 6 minutes left.
Looks like Heritage Hall switched to a 3-2 zone.
Well, that's because Coral Grimmett is out now. Number checked in for the Heritage Hall, number 22, Janelle Johnson. She's a sophomore. So that when they did that, they had to move Laney Portman to the middle now. So they, when they're in the zone, they don't have Grimmett anymore. Isaac Carter's at the top. In for the Bobcats. Somebody came in. I missed that. Samaya McCoy actually came in. Number 15 came in for the Bobcats.
Sounds like Corinthia Colbert's shot was blocked. And then Janelle Johnson called for the walk in the corner as she took a step.
Yeah, she just got off the bench, so she just has to get her legs under.
5 minutes and 5 seconds left in the half, 17-17 between Sarah Spencer and Heritage Hall.
Corinthia Colbert.
To the hole, off the mark.
Laney Portman passes it. She just did the assist to. Okay. Okay.
And I think that's...
That's a foul.
They call the foul?
Yeah.
Yeah. And I think that's Anna Walker.
That foul was on number 12. That was Reagan Kramer. That's her first personal. Star Spencer is going to bring Quinaya Brown back. Actually subbing in for Aisha Carter. Give her a breather.
Yeah.
She's been this whole first half so far.
Working hard and wanting to keep the legs fresh.
Right. So now with Aisha Carter out, Taija Walker is going to bring the ball up. And then puts Quinaya Brown on the wing. And on the other side, Candace Brady. Corinthia Colbert. She comes in. She came in shooting.
Yeah, she was ready to play.
Right.
Over the foul. That foul called on Candace Brady.
That was Candace Brady.
That was called on the floor, and they got a quick inbound while Star Spencer defense wasn't quite set.
Marley Moore took advantage of them, you know, not being ready and decided to shoot that. Something's going on. I'm not sure what happened. But we're going to do a sub.
We've got a...
Kira Trailer is going to... I think we had a quick injury timeout. Injury substitution.
They sent Candace Brady off to the bench. Got to be a trip in there somewhere. We'll call that a block on the floor. Number 00. I think that'd have to be Anna Walker.
Anna Walker.
Corinthia Colbert in the inbound. Buckets in and out. Fight for the rebound off of Star Smith's player, Heritage Hall ball. 3:58 left in the first half, 19-19 here at the Johnson & Johnson Fieldhouse. Star Spencer sets up with a press up to the line. Marley Moore breaks the press, takes the hole, 2 points.
You have my list with the referees on it?
.3:35 left in the second quarter.
I think the momentum is
Marley
changed.
Moore called for the travel as she catches a pass under the basket and skips before she can get her shot off. Quick substitution out for Spencer is that number 22?
No, number 12, Kira Traylor.
Kira Traylor. Number 11,
Capri Smith
is on the floor for the first time tonight. Ball intercepted by number 22 to Janelle Johnson at Heritage Hall. And she brings ball down, hands it off to Lainey Portman to the glass. Her shot's no good, but there's an offensive rebound, and they reset the offense. Her rebound's being tough contested rebound.
I thought that was going to be a jump ball, but it's ended up being a foul on number 12. Reagan Kramer, that's her second.
Sophia LeClerc enters the game. They'll have Reagan Kramer take a seat. They're still working. Sounds more like a...
With the steal, Marley Moore, and they're on the ground trying to get it. They go around the horn, passing around, leave her open over there. We have Janelle Johnson. No. Offensive rebound by Taysia Walker, and then there's a foul.
Like we're taking it down to the other end in the bonus.
So again, to reiterate, it's a new rule for fouls. So they start over every quarter.
And let's go straight to 1-1, or is it two shots?
Two shots.
After five fouls.
Yeah.
Five fouls for the quarter. I think I just heard the Heritage Hall coach say that they didn't want to foul Taisha Walker anymore.
Well, let's see if they stick with their plan. And here goes Taisha Walker. Let's see what happens. Capri Smith gets her hands on the ball for the first time. What? They will not want to let her heat up. She's a late addition to the team. She started practice play for whatever reason. But now that she's back, she has been a big part even last year, even in eighth grade.
And she looks like she's got good ball handling skills.
Yeah. They do not want to let Capri Smith heat up.
A quick break with Heritage Hall. At least to another Lainey Portman basket.
All right, timeout. Full timeout by Star Smith's Bobcats.
2:02 left in the second quarter. Heritage Hall finds himself with a 2-point lead, 23-21.
Right. We're at the Johnson & Johnson Fieldhouse here at Star Spencer High School. I am one of your announcers. I'm Tori Purvey.
And this is Philip Coward.
The score is 23-21. Star Spencer Bobcats 21 and Heritage Hall Chargers on the high side with 23. 2 minutes left in this half. Star Spencer ball on the far end. Now that Isaiah Carter's coming in, has gone out. Tyja Walker seems to be the person bringing up. But now I told you about Capri Smith. You know, she's late addition, but you see they put her at the top.
Put her at the top of the point, yep. Loose ball foul.
Was it a foul? Or
what do they call a kick, maybe?
Yeah, they didn't report anything, so it was probably a kick. Oh. There's Caprice.
Oh, she still picked up her dribble. She lost the handle.
Corinthia Colbert. Corinthia Colbert to Quinaya Brown. Quinaya Brown back to Corinthia Colbert and is off the mark.
Star Spencer did a good job in that possession of working the zone. They call a walk on Heritage Hall.
In for the Bobcats, Isaiah Carter.
That was a call that I wasn't expecting. It was the third call that I was thinking either it was going to be an offensive foul, a block, but was not what I was expecting.
Kendall Rowland also checks back in for the Bobcats. So Isaiah checked in for Caprice. It's 1 minute left.
Oh!
Bang!
Drains of the three.
Tyja Walker.
And another opportunity, Laney Portman answering. She's done that three or four times in the first half.
Star Spencer can't do that. They can't hit the three, get excited, celebrate, and then not get back on defense.
Right, they got to transition
that
back.
That play is over, right. Quinaya Brown.
Driving to the hole.
30 seconds left. Marley Moore brings the ball across half court and gets fouled. Wow. That foul's on Isaiah Carter. That sends Marley Moore to the free throw line.
She makes the second of the free throw. 24 seconds left. It's a tie game at 26 in the first half. Referee starts play. The clock didn't start.
Yeah, so stop it. They didn't start the clock. Quinaya Brown to Kendall Rowland. And Kendall gets her pass intercepted.
And Portman for Heritage Hall just stepped in and stole that ball. It kind of floated in, and I don't think they were expecting her to make the move in there like she was.
Kendall Rowland, her pass got intercepted, and she may have just made an emotional play and just go down there and create that foul. But that sends Anna Walker to the free throw line. She made the first one, so now she gets the second one. With 11 seconds left, and it's a Heritage Hall up 1 point, 27-26. What's Isaiah going to do? And
the big three is no good to halftime. It's a 1 point lead for Heritage Hall. Star Spencer.
So what does Star Spencer do the second half? Do they change anything, or do they just stay in the pocket with what they're going?
I think they stay with what they were doing was working. I think they lost a little bit of momentum in the second quarter.
That could be.
But there was several points that were off hustle plays and Just quick reactions by Heritage Hall that got a few more points on the scoreboard that were pretty easy points to get.
Right. It seems that Aja Carter is a she seems to be a firebrand for the team because they were doing fine when she was on the floor, and then when she got subbed out, the momentum changed.
Yeah.
And then like when the momentum changed, and then Heritage Hall seems to picked up the pace. Mm-hmm. When Aja was off the floor. But then I say that, but then Taysia Walker, she came on for the Bobcats and kept her alive.
She did definitely in the second quarter.
Right.
She was an effective force on the floor to keep Star Spencer in the game.
Right, because didn't you say that – did you hear the coach say that we didn't want – because she was on the line.
Yeah,
she was on the
line. She was – I think she's 4-for-4 at the strike.
Okay, because the coach said don't foul her.
Yeah.
Yeah. So now what about for the Heritage Hall Chargers? What do they change anything? Or do
I think they've been relying on Laney Portman and Marley Moore at the center of their offense and their transition. So anytime that there was a fast transition – it was either Moore or Portman with the ball or the rebound.
Yeah, but early on, number 15, Coral Grimmett, and she was in the middle, middle of the defense. And then she was making some moves, but she had two fouls early on. So the coach made a smart decision, I believe it was a smart decision, and, you know, decided to have her sit. But then also when she moved out the game, they moved number 12, Reagan Kramer, to the center. So I think that – I don't know if that had a – I don't know if it was a positive or a negative effect. I mean, seeing how the game is still close.
They're still close, you know? And they switched to the 2-1-2 zone and still were able to pressure Star Spencer on the ball.
All right.
We'll be back for the third quarter.
sweatsuit. He's probably on the bench with the boys because he plays basketball, but he's not suited up.
Where?
He's probably on the bench. Dude, our boys haven't come out yet.
Oh, they haven't?
So he's probably with them. But yeah, I saw him earlier.
Yell at me when he comes out.
All right. Mike, mute, unmute.
I went out to the we're back. I went up to the scoreboard just to check some things. The lead point person for Heritage Hall is Marley Moore. We said her name a few times. She has 12, and Reagan Kramer has 11.
Wow.
So those two have the – that's –
the lion's share of
right.
the that's Heritage Hall points. Yeah.
Right, that's 23 of the 28. And for the Bobcats, Quinaya Brown has 12, and Tyja Walker – only has 5. She has a 3-point and then those 2 free throws. I thought she would have more, but Quinaya Brown has 12. So it seems like the Bobcats have kind of spread their points around. Sergeant's the Bobcats get the ball for this second half.
Asia Carter moved out and then moved it back out to Corinthia. The layup off the glass is no good. Get Marley Moore brings the ball back down coast to coast. Star Spencer with the rebound. Marley Moore challenges in the backcourt against Kenai Brown. She moves over to the right side, down to the baseline.
Isaac Carter tried to cross pass.
Pass just a little bit too long.
Right, Laney Portman goes up 2 points.
Sinks the back. They have a nose for the defense. They can sniff the ball out. And
well, when you try to make a cross court pass,
that's a long
like
pass,
that.
And there's
right.
a lot of time to break on the ball.
Right, you can't balloon it. You got to zip it over there. If you're going to do it, you're going to do it. There's somebody there. Heritage Hall defense.
Another steal.
They're on it right now.
Moore to LeClerc. And back out to
Reagan
Kramer. Marley Moore at the top of the key. Drives in, throws out to Kramer. Down to the post. Coral Grimmett. Offensive foul call. Oh. I didn't see that. That move.
That's her third foul. So she didn't play the second quarter because she had those 2 fouls.
Yep, so
and now she came in and got a quick one.
Spencer moves it around the top of the key.
With her having 3
out
fouls.
To Kendall Rowland.
I think Coach Nixon's going to have some decisions to make as far as what to do with Grimmett. Leave
right.
on the floor or not.
Candace like Brady takes a shot and misses a little bit long. And then we're back with Laney Portman.
Anna Walker shoots. It comes up on the other side.
And Marley Moore on the offensive board.
She's directing traffic. She's trying to set a play up. Goes back to Anna Walker. Anna Walker drives.
Oh.
And foul. Oh. That foul, like, oh, I guess, was it a blocking foul?
It looked like something, but it looked initially like Brady had her feet caught up, but then in the fall, I guess, committed the foul as she was falling down.
Well, that foul was on. They reported.
Oh, they reported. Ah,
number 15.
An offensive foul.
Right. So she has 4 fouls, and the coach sat her down.
The 5.5 left in the third quarter is way too early to have foul trouble. And Candace Brady took the step before she took the dribble. It's called for the walk. And throughout the night, through this game and the boys' game, the referees, I think, have been consistent in calling the traveling.
Yeah, we got Billy Terong, Rick Dupree, and Princeton Johnson for refs. They're doing a real good job.
Candace Brady called for the foul at the baseline.
And that's her fourth. That's her fourth personal.
And she'd be a player to hate to lose for the rest of the game.
Right.
With foul trouble, so she'll take a seat. And Mari Hill come into the game for the first time.
So each team has lost a good player, a starter.
Yep, to foul trouble.
Marley Moore eyes the rim, eyes the basket, but it's off the mark, and she goes.
She gets
again.
A second try.
Anna Walker. They settle for two.
Yeah, I think that's Sophia LeClaire, number one. Is that right? Number one, Sophia LeClaire.
Uh-huh.
LeClaire.
The timeout.
So with 4:46 left in the third quarter, 32-26 Heritage Hall leads Star Spencer.
It's a 30-second timeout. I missed who called the timeout. Both being 30 seconds. Somebody's trying to regroup. It's 32-26. 32-26 Heritage Hall on the high side. Star Spencer Bobcats 26. Each team has had a starter in foul trouble with four fouls.
Early foul trouble, yeah.
Right. So for the Heritage Hall, it's Coral Grimmett. She has four. And for the Star Spencer Bobcats, Candace Brady, sophomore, she has four fouls. Candace Brady has been replaced by Amari Hill, a freshman. This is her first time seeing the court tonight, right?
Yep, I think so. Heritage Hall sets back up. Looks like a good 3-2 zone. Ready to meet the Bobcats at the top of the arc.
In this situation, I think a 3-2 zone has the potential to work.
Yep.
You know, it kind of slows the game down. It keeps the offense from being too aggressive.
That's right. You got lots of bodies near the basket. And it's going to take some patience to move the ball closer to get those high percentage of shots.
Kira Traylor checks in for the Bobcats.
And that shot's blocked.
Isaiah Carter brings the ball up past half court. She tries to work the baseline, and she dishes it to Kira Traylor. Kira Traylor.
Off the glass.
Off the glass. Kira Traylor is also a freshman.
Star Spencer. The freshmen are making an impact on the game tonight. Janelle Johnson with the offensive rebound and puts it back up for 2 points for Heritage Hall. Asia Carter working points. Comes into the Heritage Hall zone defense.
They have to retaliate. They have to have some sort of comeback because it just like that by Quinaya Brown.
And that was a good example of where they took advantage of the aggressiveness on defense. The Heritage Hall player dove in for the interception, and they were able to get the bucket and 2 points out of that.
Lainey Portman goes up for three, doesn't make it, but Anna Walker gets the rebound. Also back, and then Janelle. Star Spencer doesn't seem to be going for any defensive rebounds.
That's what I was just thinking, that there was three Heritage Hall players under the bucket with only one Star Spencer player in the bucket, and that's going to hurt if you can't rebound the ball and
stop the momentum.
Stop the momentum, exactly. Kramer drops it into Portman. Back to Kramer for the three is long. The air ball, quick transition, and Star Spencer loses the ball. Kira Traylor couldn't quite keep the handle. Back to LeClaire. 15-foot jumper from the corner is rebounded by Corinthia Colbert, but I think she stepped on the baseline.
She stepped out of bounds. Isaiah Carter, she had eyes. She sees the court, which is good. But you also have to remember the personnel that you have in the game.
Yep.
Some plays you can't do because they don't have that athleticism.
Down to the low post to Janelle Johnson. Off the mark.
Corinthia Colbert with the rebound, and she's bringing it across half court.
It's almost like Star Spencer heard us talking about their rebound, and they got last two possessions a little more aggressive on the defensive board. That shot falls short with Portman for the rebound. Star Spencer almost had him tied up in the backcourt.
Yeah, Marley Moore passes it to to Janelle Johnson.
That was a good block by Kendall Rowland. Again, call her name on defense.
Right.
So she's got a good defensive nose and has at least two blocks tonight that we've seen. Corinthia Colbert working the corner, works it back to Asia Carter, and then she's going to the boards. Loses the handle. The ball gets tied up in the middle of the lane. Jump ball for
possession goes to Heritage Hall.
Heritage Hall.
I think Star Spencer can use this time with them in the zone since they're sitting back, figure out something, and just like they did, they're making their way to the basket.
Yeah, and they've cut the lead down. We're down to a 4-point lead with a minute 45 left in the third.
Right, but Heritage Hall, there seems to be running. Like, their game is fast-paced.
Yep.
A lot of passes, a lot of quick passes.
A walk, Janelle Johnson shuffling her feet inside the lane, turns the ball back over, and gives Star Spencer another chance to cut the lead.
I think we'll be in Bobcat's favor if they would slow it down. Just like they now, walking the ball up the court now and just take the time and let things happen.
Off the high glass, rebounded by Heritage Hall.
And a walker. Passes across half
but
court.
I think that was an effective way. I mean, running the offense a little bit slower is essentially a timeout for the other team to break their momentum if you can keep possession.
Right. And now we're under a minute.
Yeah, and Corinthia Colbert jumped in. I think that was a good foul for her when she's only got – that's only, didn't have any fouls on the night. To really put some big obstacles in front of Heritage Hall to move the ball.
Checking in for the Bobcats, Tiaja Walker.
Janelle Johnson picks up her dribble outside. She takes the foul under the basket. Let's see, they'll call that a shooting foul. Send Janelle Johnson to the line. And that was caught.
That was on Kanaya Brown.
Kanaya Brown.
Yeah, that's her second personal. Janelle Johnson, she makes the front end of her two shots. Checking in for the Bobcats, Andrea Perez. And just like that, it's now a 6-point game.
Back to 6 points and 45 seconds left in the quarter.
Right. And the style of play that these girls are playing, 6 points can be a lot.
Yeah, it can be a lot.
But it's only third quarter.
That's right.
Bobcats playing that man-on-man defense, trying to make something happen.
There
just
we go,
like
with
that.
With the steal. Brown with the steal. And Johnson quickly steals it back. Walker works it out to Portman. Heritage Hall working for the
Johnson.
Last shot of the quarter.
They trust Johnson because she's been putting it up a lot lately. And at the end of three, Star Spencer Bobcats 30, Heritage Hall 36.
And that was a really clean end of the quarter where that had opportunity that could have had a bad outcome.
Right.
And send somebody else to the line, more points with no time on the clock.
Right.
So I think here, 8 minutes to go in the game, the fourth quarter, keeps that lead manageable. I think that we may get to the point where we're going to have to pressure Heritage Hall
right.
to make some mistakes and then have them make mistakes and miss some buckets and then increase the field goal percentages, the shots from the floor to get those points caught back up on the
Speaking of percentages, that's what I was saying. Like 6 points can seem like a lot of points for this style of play that both teams are playing because their percentages are low. It's like they're not always hitting. When their free throws, decent.
Yep.
But, like, it's a lot of rebounding.
Field goal percentage is pretty low, right? Lower than what it needs to be.
Yeah. So what do you think the coach is telling the team right here?
I think it has to be talking about the patience on defense. And this time, it's an advantage for Heritage Hall for Star Spencer to work a slow offense.
I was just about to say.
And start milking the clock.
You may see
Heritage Hall slow down their offense, hold the ball longer. I mean, the advantage of being in a high school basketball, there is no shot clock.
In Oklahoma, right.
So you can take your time on the possession. And we may see that.
Well, it seemed like time management it would be in the – will behoove both teams, you know, to try to manage the clock.
Yep.
Even if Star Spencer is down by six, still manage the clock so the lead won't get any bigger.
That's right. Anna Brown called for the kickball. Star Spencer will take it out. Kenai Brown, top of the key. Quick hands from Marley Moore leads to the turnover.
Isaac Carter
to Walker.
Turns the ball over.
Double
zero, Anna Walker.
Walker makes the bucket on the breakaway.
Andrea Perez.
Passes to the low post. Can't keep the handle.
Everybody's on the ground. No possession yet. Kendall Rowland comes up with the ball.
And the foul. Send her to the line for two. That was called on Janelle Johnson.
That's our first.
Can you hear us on yours?
No, but I can hear y'all on my phone.
Kendall Rowland to the free throw. She misses the front end.
Those are valuable points that you can't get up on the scoreboard.
Especially at this time, last quarter, they need these points.
More to Walker. Walker works it down to the top of the key, and Portman misses the layup. It's an opportunity for Star Spencer to narrow the gap. Anytime they can transition the floor without Heritage Hall putting points up, that's an advantage for Star Spencer. Carter takes it out at the top, works it in, and works. It gets kicked back out to her. Candace Brady to the baseline and off the top of the goal. It'll be a turnover back to Heritage Hall. And that's kind of seemed like a shot that she wasn't really set. She wasn't squared up to the basket, and didn't end up working out what she needed for Star Spencer.
Lainey Portman to Anna Walker. Anna Walker to Kramer. Kramer back to Walker. Walker back to Portland. Portland to Kramer. She shoots.
That high three-point play.
3 points. That was Reagan Kramer in timeout. Stars.
Got to break
Bobcat.
It now. We're at 6 minutes left in the fourth.
Well,
10-point lead is
right,
suddenly looks really big.
Right, that 6 points is now 10 points. That's what I was saying. It can kind of – if 6 points looks big for this caliber play, 10 points
– is huge.
Right. It's not too late. Not too late. Still a lot of game left.
Yep. You gotta,
but now we're talking about
– make the buckets. You got to – increase
right.
your field goal percentage.
Right, time management.
And still hope and still force Heritage Hall mistakes.
Yes. Well, it seems that Heritage Hall, they haven't slowed the game down.
No, they
Heritage
haven't.
Hall, they're pushing.
They still are pushing.
But they're making enough mistakes that Star Spencer could capitalize it if they would see that they're pushing, figure out why they're pushing,
yep.
and then when they make mistakes, get people in to rebound.
Yep.
Because we saw a couple possessions where Heritage Hall got three offensive rebounds back-to-back-to-back.
Right, and you cannot give extra possessions to the team you're trying to catch up to.
Right. Exactly. So at this point, you have down 10, 6 minutes left. Coach Caldwell for the Bobcats, what do you think she's telling the team?
Got You gotta take the shots, but you gotta make those shots. You gotta take a extra instance, shorten up the passes, move the ball quickly, but move it effectively. Yeah, that's kind of a 50-50 ball down at the top of the key that was a pretty low chance of completing that pass.
All right, Lainey Portman, she's been very aggressive on this half too. Quinaya Brown goes coast to coast. She does not make it. But guess who got the rebound? Lainey Portman.
Yep.
And now she brings it back. She's going to go up again. And it's a foul. That foul is on Aja Carter. That's her second personal.
So they called that on the floor. So they give Spencer an opportunity to play defense again.
I'm sorry. I've been calling her Lainey Portman. That's Marley Moore.
Marley Moore. Portman inside. That's
Portman.
Portman right there.
That's Portman. Marley Moore has been the one that's been bringing the ball up.
Yep. The pass inside's good at the post, and it just can't fall.
Kramer gets the rebound.
Pass over to Moore.
Pass to Moore.
Now they're starting to slow it down. 5 minutes and 10 seconds left in the fourth.
Well, it's 12 points, so it's up to the Bobcats to score. Moore to Portman.
And they're starting to see some fatigue in Star Spencer. They're losing their men, or losing their marks on the inside in the man-to-man defense. So that's given Heritage Hall a chance to find those open shots.
Right. And seeing it's turnovers like that, that's probably going to make this game, might blow this game wide open. Anna Walker with the steal and the layup. 47-31, 4.5 minutes left in the fourth quarter. Here at Johnson Johnson Fieldhouse, Star Spencer High School. Star Spencer Bobcats versus Heritage Hall Chargers. Kendall Rowland goes up. It gets blocked. Out of bounds. Bobcat ball.
Now I think with 4:20 left in the fourth, I think it's going to be its time that to consider getting those girls that are in foul trouble back on the floor.
Yes.
To recapture the momentum. Kirthy Colbert had a good look at the basket, didn't fall for her, and then we have Marley Moore coming back again. Yep, and we saw the stutter step and the walk. I think sometimes it's tough for a referee to get the stutter step and the foul at close to the same time. That's a tough call to make.
Right.
A floater from about 12 feet. That was a good shot.
Now will be a great time for a momentum change for the Bobcats.
A clean steal.
Maybe this is the momentum change that they
need. There we go.
There's Aja Carter again. It's now 12 points.
And keep defense, yeah.
Right, and I see Candace Brady's getting ready to check in for the Bobcats. It looked like she was. She's the one with four fouls. I think they may be doing all right without her right now, but we'll see.
Hey, look at Heritage Hall. I think they call this the swinging door.
And momentum change again.
Momentum change.
Star Spencer and Bobcats. Kendall Rowland.
They put in the basket.
So that's six unanswered points right there for the Bobcats, which brings them within 10.
There we go. Just under 3 minutes left in the fourth. And there's some mistakes is where Marley Moore has been a layup machine tonight. Corinthia Colbert takes it down, looking back, takes the ball back for a more high percentage shot, working back and forth between Aja Carter for three is off the mark, but they get the offensive board from Brown.
So right now, Bobcats have six unanswered points. But that's the momentum change that we're thinking they
captured the momentum.
Right. That foul's on Lainey Portman. That's her second personal. That sends Quinaya Brown to the free throw line shooting two. we see Coach Caldwell for the Bobcats talking to the ref. She's in the ear of the ref, trying to make sure that everything is okay. And then we can also see Coach Nixon for the Chargers talking to Marley Moore, trying to make a game plan for these last 2.5 minutes.
That's right, because the coach sees the momentum shift, and then the star Spencer is really trying to get any little thing to get in the referee's ear to look for those fouls. I think that'll be star Spencer ball. It's a good effort. Those stands are not soft. 2:15 left in the fourth. A loose ball, still not quite recovered by Heritage Hall. Star Spencer has a chance to secure it. And Age Carter secures the steal.
Yeah, Corinthia Colbert brings the ball across half court. Aja Carter to Kanai Brown. Kanai Brown to McCoy. McCoy's in the paint, loses it. Laney Portman for two.
49-37, 1:45 left. Is that a loose pass to the top of the key, intercepted by Portman.
...89 seconds left in this game. Star Spencer Bobcats, they'll be playing tomorrow back here at the Star Spencer Johnson Fieldhouse, and the Heritage Hall Chargers were playing on the 12th.
Corinthia Colbert to the line, a chance to make it a 10-point game.
Their foul's on number 3, Laney Portman. That's her third personal.
Moore brings it down the floor for Heritage Hall.
They're spreading it out now. They know that the game is in hand. The game is in hand, so they're just trying not to make sure nothing bad happens. Coach Nixon for the Chargers is telling them not to shoot. But sometimes you can't take away the killer instinct. You can say shoot, but it's right there, coach.
It works the clock. You got to shoot.
Right. That was Kramer for two. Janelle Johnson gets that defensive rebound, but it's knocked out by Aja Carter. So that's going to be Chargers ball.
And that was the opportunity I think Star Spencer had at the end of the fourth quarter was those 10-foot shots right in front of the basket. And then that just closed up in the last minute, Heritage Hall's defense. seconds, 51-37, Heritage Hall leads.
Kramer passes the ball into Walker, and it's a foul. By Corinthia Colbert, that's their first personal. I think Star Spencer, they're trying to, I don't know why. I have 16 seconds left. I don't know if they're trying to make
well, get to the and this reserve. I think this is where we see the new rule kind of speeding up the game. When there's not, you're not sending people to the line, you're not given the chance to turn over the possession. You're just giving the ball back and resetting the possession.
Right.
Until unlike you were in the bonus.
Right.
So it's going to, if you're not managing your fouls, it may take you a few fouls to get to the bonus to where you get that change of possession and give them give your opponent a chance to miss the free throws.
All right, that's classy moves by the Chargers, by the coach, by Liv and Nixon, telling them not to score. You know, just like, hey, the game is in hand, just pass the ball and just, you know, let the clock run out.
Yeah.
And good on the players, too, for the most part, following the coaches. the coach's direction. Star Spencer trying to make something happen in these last few seconds, so they're fouling. Marley Moore goes to the line. She hits the front end of her two shots. And she hits both of them. And that's the game. Starts the Bobcats 37, Heritage Hall 53.
And I think that was a good game. And then there was just a few instances in starting at the halfway through the third quarter that Star Spencer let the ball game kind of slip away. But also it was a good play and good offense by Heritage Hall that they were to build a lead and maintain that lead through the end of the fourth quarter.
Right. Looking at the players for Star Spencer, they 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It only seven players played the entire game for Star Spencer.
Yeah.
Only seven players got in the game.
Yeah, and that's
so you're trying to play a whole game with seven people, two reserves.
And that's a testament to having a deep bench.
Right. Eight people.
Keeping the bench fresh.
Right. Yeah. Versus Heritage Hall. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Well, they had seven. So they kind of, you know, had the same amount of people in the game. I think the game was – it was a great game until maybe the last 3 minutes.
Yeah, I definitely agree. But it was a great time. I enjoyed working with you. First time on the air together. Like another more nights to come of
All right.
calling Star Spencer basketball.
Star Spencer basketball tomorrow here, same place. Weather permitting. Torrey Purvey. And
Philip Coward. We'll see you later.
Yep, I'm out.